I have always written, even since I was a little girl. I wrote short stories for friends and families. And then that developed and expanded. I wrote longer and longer stories, but I never finished any books. I was very careful about that kind of writing because I said to myself, it will be about having fun. It will be about having lust, passion for writing. And if I didn't feel like writing, I shouldn't finish any projects. But in 2007, I was, in a situation in life where you feel that you need something new, something extra. Things were not going that well at work. There had been some private developments that made me a bit stressed. And I needed a new project. I needed a new dimension in life, or how to say it. And then I decided that I would, for the first time, try to write a whole novel, and then I wrote Unwanted. And it was fantastic to print it the first time from the computer, knowing that I made it, I wrote a book. I had had a friend who had told me, you have to reach page 90, because then you will not be able to stop. So I actually wrote 90 pages in 7 days. And then I was completely exhausted, but I also looked at it, it's like, hey, this is like one third of a book or a fourth or whatever, how long you plan to be. He's right, I can't stop now. So in order to heal, I wrote basically, both mentally and physically. And it was really a rapid work. I had it finished basically by Christmas. He says, to write is human, to edit is divine. And I think that he's very, very right on that one. When you write as fast as I do, at least with the first two or three books, it's very hard to nail the text on the first try. You have to rewrite chapters or parts and change words. And also quite many, you write so fast, so you spell words incorrectly just because you're in such a hurry. That was something that I had to work quite a lot with once the manuscript was done. And then when I came to the publishing house, of course, they had even more suggestions. And I remember when I first got, they printed the manuscript and made notes, in the margin and gave it back to me. And I was like, oh, holy crap. It was so many comments. At least I thought then it was quite many comments. But then when I began to work with them and process it, it's like, hey, these are actually quite small changes, and they still have a major impact on the text as such, on the whole. And that was just magic and an eye-opener that I know how to write a book, but Anna, my editor, she can make it perfect. And so I totally back Stephen King up. To write is human, to edit is divine. So Anna is divine and I am only human in this process. That was amazing to get that opportunity. They say that they get around 1,000 manuscripts and they choose like one or two. I don't know how I did it. I just decided that when I sent the manuscript to them, it would be as good as it could be. I would not do a hasty work. I would try to make it perfect with my own tools and confidence. I also made a huge effort to, you enclose a letter with your manuscript where you describe yourself and your work. And I worked so hard on that letter because I thought if they get 1,000 manuscripts, I bet they read something from each, but they don't read much. So if you don't write perfect two or three or five first pages, you're just smoked. They will not continue to read something that seems wrong or bad. So I made a huge effort to give a good first impression. And they said afterwards, they told me that they did like the letter. They did like the opening of the book. And they felt that I had the energy to keep writing and was willing to learn and work with them. And I think that as a whole made me a package that they found attractive. I choose it for the very nasty reason that it's everyone's nightmare. I knew that I wanted to write some kind of terrible story, bearing in mind that I do love Stephen King's work. I had to make it very nasty, I thought. Some things, yes, and also some of her characteristics. We are both kind of lost in terms of career moves and dreams and plans. We used to be really, really tight when it came to family thinking. She starts out as this single girl who is dating a married man. I'm not dating a married man, but otherwise we were very similar. In Sweden we have had 4 books in the series published, and now she's actually married and has 2 children. And I felt a great sorrow when I finished the 4th book, like, oh my god, I used to be so close to this girl and now she has like become so old and mature and she's living a completely different life. From the beginning I said to myself, okay, 5 to 6 books and then I would give it, take a pause and give it some sort of time to think about, okay, where is Fredrika in life? Is she getting boring for the readers? Am I becoming too dependent on her or maybe too comfortable? I have read authors who have written book after book, book after book about the same character. And in the end, they seem to lose interest for their own books. And I don't want that to happen to me. I want the party to end when it is at its best. And maybe start writing about different characters, or if I move Fredrika to another context, maybe she can work with something else. I mean, she has a very broad background. No way, nowhere near. I explained earlier that it's, to me, when I wrote the book, it was a very, very private project. It was my private child dream to write a book. And I say that over and over again when I sometimes give speeches or briefings to people. I don't ever let anyone take that away from you. If you have written a book, you have written a book. It doesn't have to be published to be a book. It's still a book and you're still an author. So when I printed it from my computer in my very own apartment, only for myself, it's like, I made it. And that was it. That was all I really needed to see. Everything else has been extra and it has been fantastic and so beyond what I could ever imagine. Dennis Lehane is a great star, I would say. He has inspired me quite heavily. I'm also a big fan of John Connolly, the Irish writer, Peter Robinson, Harlan Coben. As for Scandinavian writers, I'm a huge fan of Jo Nesbø, Anne Holt, and in Sweden I like Åsa Larsson, Johan Theorin, Roslund and Hellström, Måns Kallentoft. Well, there are quite many of them that I like. I like Kepler as well. I know that they're quite big here. So I read a lot, actually. I haven't been reading as much as I normally do this winter, but otherwise I read a lot. I think it has become like a sport in Sweden. I think that we had some very early and big successes with Sjöwall Wahlöö starting out, and then Henning Mankell, and Lisa Marklund breaking grounds, followed by Camilla Läckberg, and of course Stieg Larsson. These people have had the same impact on writing as Ingmar Stenmark once had on skiing in Sweden, and Björn Borg on tennis. Once you have a star, everyone has someone to look up on, a success to follow and think, hey, if he could do that, I think I could try as well. I think that the most important advice I can give is to write. It's when you write that you learn how to write and read. It's when you read that you get the language, the structure of a book. If you don't read a lot and if you don't write a lot, you will never ever make it. I would say you cannot compensate it by doing some summer course or doing a course after work. In Sweden that's very popular to buy some sort of writing training course, whatever. I don't believe in that at all. I have never attended any of these courses. You get the knowledge and know-how by looking at previous works, that is books, and you train yourself by writing.